السلام عليكم ورحمة الله. All praise is due to Allah. We praise Him, we seek His aid, His guidance, His forgiveness. We seek refuge with Allah from the evil actions and evil consequences of our bad deeds. Whomever Allah guides, nobody can misguide him. And whomever Allah misguides, nobody can guide him. I bear witness, there is no God worthy of worship except Allah alone, having no partners. And I bear witness that Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam is his slave and last messenger sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. To proceed, today we have lesson 8. It's a very, very important class and very easy, and all the time you find it while you are reading Quran or talking or reading or any Arabic texts. Inshallah, I want you to concentrate with me, inshallah, and try to be close to the keyboard to answer any question. After we finished reviewing the verbs, al-af'al, today we're going to study al-asma', the nouns. And from now and then, inshallah, we will divide the asma into three groups. First, we talk about al-marfu'a, al-asma al-marfu'a. And then after we finish 7 classes al-asma al-marfu'a, we will take al-asma al-mansuba. Will be double this, like 15 or 14, 15. And then after that, we will take al-asma al-makhfuda, all or al-majrura, will be only 3. Now, al-asma al-marfu'a, 7. 7 marfu' nouns, yani 7 categories, 7 types of asma or nouns. They always come in the sentence marfu'a. The first one is al-fa'il, the subject, the doer, al-fa'il. The second one, the alternate fa'il or alternate subject, yani the one who comes on behalf of the fa'il. We will take all of this, inshallah, in details, but today, inshallah, we talk about the fa'il only. Number 3, al-mubtada, the noun which start the sentence. We call it al-mubtada, yani we start with it, the starter. The khabar means the other noun or the sentence which complete the meaning with the mubtada. And then ism kana and khabar inna. You have to remember this chart as much as you can. Every time we repeat it and we will ask about it, the 7 nouns which come marfu'a, al-fa'il, na'ib al-fa'il, al-mubtada, al-khabar, ism kana, khabar inna, wa-tabi' lil-marfu' the follower of marfu'. Yani if you have a noun marfu' because it's following a marfu' preceded marfu' word, there are 4 types come followers, 4 types of tawabi' marfu'. I mean 4 tawabi' or 4 types of followers. They follow us in the marfu' nouns and in the mansub nouns, in the makhfud nouns. All of these types, they will come with us, the followers. The followers, yani, they don't have a special i'rab. No, they follow. If they follow the marfu' will be marfu', follow mansub will be mansub, follow makhfud will be makhfud. What type of followers we have? We have 4 types of followers. The first one is the adjective, the sifa or na'at. The second one, conjunction or atf. The third one, affirmation or tawkeed. The fourth one, alternative or badal. We will take all of these in details. There's no chance to give a lot of examples and to confuse you. We will try to concentrate only today on al-fa'il. The first one, al-fa'il, the doer, the subject. First, we're going to say there are nominal sentence, يعني start with name, or noun, noun, start with noun. We call mubtada and khabar. The nominal sentence has two corners or pillars, mubtada and khabar. We are not talking about it today. We take the other one, the verbal sentence, which comprises of three parts. Two of them are mandatory as they are pillars, the verb and the fa'il, the doer of the action, the subject. The third is optional to be mentioned, which is the object. Some sentences, they need object. Some sentences, you don't find object, which is al-maf'ul bi. But we'll concentrate today on al-fa'il, the subject. The subject is the marfu' noun that is preceded by its verb. This is very important to pay attention to, that every verb has a doer or fa'il or subject. The verb has to come first, then the subject in the sentence. If the subject come first, will not be subject anymore, will be mubtada, because you started the sentence with noun, will be mubtada, will not be fa'il. The fa'il has to follow the verb. The verb has to come first in the verbal sentence, okay? This verb occurs in two forms. The fa'il, the subject occurs in two forms. يعني you search for the fa'il in the sentence, you find it comes in two forms. Either it comes apparent, name or noun, or a representative pronoun. For example, if we have وَوَرِثَ سُلَيْمَانُ دَاوُدَ, here is a verb. وَوَرِثَ means he inherited. Who is the one who did this verb? سُلَيْمَانُ. You have noun here and مَرْفُوع with Dhamma. سُلَيْمَانُ, he's the fa'il, he's the subject. He inherited دَاوُدَ. داود is the object, مفعول به. Inherited him in the prophethood. طيب. Now it's very easy. We find the verb and the فاعل. Now most important that the فاعل comes after the verb. This فعل ماضي مبني على الفتح and this is فاعل مرفوع علامة رفعه الضمة. The sign is ضمة for the subject. طيب. This here is apparent and is clear and is mentioned here in the sentence. This is the first type of fa'il. It could be mentioned like clear noun after the verb. The second type of the fa'il comes in the sentence as a pronoun. Pronoun. The pronoun itself could be mentioned or hidden. يعني 99% percent will be mentioned and 1% will be hidden. Type. Here the subject noun is mentioned openly, which is Sulaiman. Type. يرجعون is verb from the five verbs. فعل مضارع من الأفعال الخمسة. صح؟ مرفوع. The sign of رفع is ثبوت النون. The noon is there for the فعل. طيب, where the fa'il? The waw. The waw is the subject. The fa'il, huh? The doer, is damir, pronoun, mabni ala sukoon, fi mahal rafa, in the place of rafa, as fa'il. If you understood until here, please mention for me type one only, or type alhamdulillah, type one, or alhamdulillah, let me see. Who is following, if it is easy, alhamdulillah, everything is easy. الحمد لله الحمد لله. Any question until now? We are starting only. طيب, the pronouns, what the number of the pronouns? We have 12 pronouns. Remember this number. All the time remember this number. If I ask you how many pronouns we have, ضمائر, الضمائر, 12. They are always مبني. Always مبني. يعني you don't find any ضمير مرفوع or منصوب or مجرور. It has to be مبني. For واو and ألف and ياء مبني on سكون. The rest could be مبني on something else. طيب. We have 12 pronouns. Two of them for the speakers. يعني أنا. This is the speaker. نحن. Huh? For the speaker. Five for مخاطب, the second person, means أنت, أنتي, أنتما, أنتم, أنتن. Five for the absent, he, the third person, he which is هو, هي, هما, هم, هن. This, we're gonna mention that these type of pronouns in three classes. First, in the subject, الفاعل. يا نعم متكلم متكلم ومخاطب وغائب absent غائب. We're gonna mention them again in the alternate subject. نائب الفاعل, the one who comes on behalf of فاعل, also the following class, and the اسم كان, also we're gonna mention these pronouns again. طيب, now we're gonna see the rules for the subject. The rules for the subject are as follows. Number one, the فاعل has to be preceded by a verb. Remember, when you have a sentence, don't pick up the noun comes before the verb and tell me this is the فاعل. No, it's impossible. Impossible. The فاعل has to follow the verb, not to come before the verb. Remember this very well. Huh? The فاعل has to be preceded by a verb, the action. Otherwise, if you have a noun before the verb, it won't be a subject. It will be مبتدأ, مبتدأ, not فاعل. Hmm? طيب, you cannot delete the subject in the sentence. Every sentence has verb, it has to have subject, فاعل. You can't delete it because it is a pillar in the sentence. Either it is an apparent noun, as we took وَوَرِثَ سُلَيْمَانُ دَاوُدُ here, or it may be a pronoun. Noun or pronoun, ضمير. The verb matches the subject in number, يعني يكون مفرد مثله مفرد مثنى جمع as well as the gender. The فاعل and the فعل they match, but it can be singular. The verb can be singular and followed by dual or plural sometimes. We're gonna see this in the chart inshallah. But if it is a pronoun, it has to match. طيب, the ظاهر, the apparent فاعل could match the verb in إفراد, يعني the number, مفرد, يعني singular, or مثنى, dual, or جمع, plural, and in the gender. And sometimes the verb is singular and could follow by, could be followed by subject singular or not singular, like قامت هند, تقوم هند, and we could say قام الزيداني. الزيدان here single, مثنى, يعني dual. وقام الزيدون, the verb is singular. This could happen if the فاعل is apparent. You could say the verb singular or matching. But if it is ضمير, it has to match. طيب. You have to put التأنيث at the end of the past tense verb or at the beginning of مضارع if the present tense if the subject is true feminine. Yeah, here you say قامت with تاء. This تاء التأنيث just a letter حرف مبني على السكون for the feminine. If I give you قامت only you can't say زايد, you can't say masculine, you have to give me a feminine because I give you تاء التأنيث, you give me the فاعل is a feminine, مؤنث حقيقي. If I say تقوم, you can't say زايد, you have to say a female. Is understandable إن شاء الله؟ Why the فعل can't be deleted? Because it's a pillar in the sentence. It's a pillar in the sentence. Every verb has a subject. Every verb has a subject. If you find verb in the sentence, you have to find the one who did it. The one who did this action. Five. The تاء is optional. Here the تاء is mandatory for the true feminine, like Hind or Aisha or any female. Five. The تاء is optional when it is metaphorically feminine. يعني مجازي التأنيث. يعني something is not يعني get pregnant and deliver children. يعني is not true مؤنث. Like الشمس, for example, we talk about شمس like a feminine. We say طلع الشمس or طلعت الشمس. You could add or take that تاء for the one who is not true مؤنث, is not true feminine. We could say قام الرجال وقامت الرجال. قام الهنود وقامت الهنود. The جمع تكسير also we treat it as the مؤنث مجازي. We treat it as the metaphorically feminine. قام الرجال or قامت الرجال. You could say both right. When it has تاء, you are talking about the group of the men. The group of men. You say قامت as a group. جماعة, جماعة الرجال. قام الهنود وقامت الهنود. You could both right. طلع الشمس وطلعت الشمس. All of them right. It's optional to have تاء if it is metaphorically feminine or تأنيث مجازي. I'm repeating now. And because the time, I have certain time, you could repeat the verb, I mean the video, many times as much as you can. But for مفرد, دول, and جمع, تصحيح means جمع مذكر سالم or جمع مؤنث سالم, you have to have, you could treat it as مفرد. You say قام الزيداني. قام الزيدون وزود تاء. I mean وزود تاء. What time you put تاء? If it is true feminine or مجازي means the metaphorically feminine. يعني it's not true feminine. Like the sun, like جمع تكسير, we treat it as metaphorically feminine. We say قام or قامت. يعني you could put تاء or take the تاء away. But the تاء has to be there when it is true feminine. قامت هند. تقوم هند. طيب, for the دول and the جمع مذكر سالم or جمع مؤنث سالم, we treat it as مفرد is okay. قام for the verb, I mean the verb. قام الزيدان. قام الزيدون. قامت المسلمتان. قامت المسلمات. All of these verb and subject. فعل وفاعل. فعل وفاعل. طيب, the object يعني the مفعول به, the third part of the verbal sentence may come before the subject. And this is optional because the normal sequence, you have the verb followed by the doer, the subject, the فاعل, and then the object. But sometimes sometimes you find the object moving. Sometimes come before the verb, between the verb and the subject, and sometimes comes in its place, the third place. Type. We say the object may come before the subject. Yani you put it between the verb and the fa'il. We have some sentences like this for a certain eloquence, yani, yani importance in the sentence. Sometimes Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala wants you to concentrate on the object. He say, وَلَقَدْ جَاءَ آلَ فِرْعَوْنَ النُّذُرُ. Yani remember, آلَ فِرْعَوْنَ got نُذُرُ. النُذُرُ here is the noun which has dhamma. Al-marfu'a means this is the subject. جَاءَ نُذُرُ. نُذُرُ yani warning came to Al-Fir'aun. Means prophets like Musa. Prophet like Musa wa Harun. وَلَقَدْ جَاءَ آلَ فِرْعَوْنَ النُّذُرُ. النذر is the فاعل, the subject. طب آلة منصوبة. This is the object. It came between the verb and the subject. It's okay. Sometimes we have this sequence for certain importance in the sentence. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala wants to pay your attention that آلة فرعون got a lot of warning. Here, sometimes this is optional to come. وَلَقَدْ جَاءَ أَلَ فِرْعَوْنَ النُّذُرُ or وَلَقَدْ جَاءَ النُّذُرُ أَلَ فِرْعَوْنَ. You could say this way and this way. It's optional. Or it could be mandatory when it is damir connected to the verb. This means you can't break the damir and take it after the subject. Here, شَغَلَتْنَا أَمْوَالُنَا. أَمْوَالُ is the subject. The فاعل مرفوع here. طيب, here the verb. شَغَلَ. شغلة is a verb. شغلت because feminine. أموالنا is feminine. يعني الأموال, the money made us busy. يعني they are taking time to have business and this what make them busy. Then they don't want to go to the war with the Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم. They say شغلتنا أموالنا وأهلنا فاستغفر الله. Anyway, شغلت is the verb, فعل ماضي مبني على الفتح, والتاء تاء التأنيث, نا is ضمير, connected ضمير, attached ضمير, يعني ضمير متصل, مبني على السكون, because ends with ألف, في محل نصب مفعول به, يعني it's in the place of نصب as an object, and أمواله is the فاعل, أمواله is the فاعل, the subject. Here we have the object before the fa'il because it's damir connected to the verb. We can't break it and bring it after. Huh? This mandatory to come the object before the subject because it is a pronoun that is connected or attached to the verb. Also here, وَإِذِ بَتَلَى إِبْرَاهِيمَ رَبُّهُ. Where is the subject here? Where is the fa'il? رَبُّ. It has the noun which has dhamma, is the fa'il, the subject. طيب. The object came before it. Why? Because there is dhamir here attached to the fa'il. It has to be referring to the noun came before the fa'il, which is Ibrahim. Rabbuhu ilha here. Is referring to Ibrahim. This ha is referring to Ibrahim. Ta'ud ala Ibrahim. This means you have to mention the maf'ul before it, before the fa'al for this reason. This is the only reasons. It could be optional or mandatory if it is a damir connected to the verb or connected to the subject. This is the object. This is something yani, like branched about the subject. But let us concentrate again. This is the object came before the subject, but after the verb, huh? After the verb, but before the subject, before the fa'il. Here, after the verb, but before the fa'il. After the verb, but before the fa'il. But here in number 8, even the object which is maf'ul bi came all the way before the fa'il, even before the verb. The first thing came is maf'ul bihi. Yeah, because of maf'ul bihi, the object is not a pillar. Means you could move it as you like. You could delete it even. You could delete it or bring it before the subject, before the fa'il, between the fa'il and the fa'il, or even before the fa'il. Because it's not a pillar, it's not a rock, it's not a corner in the sentence. You mean you could move it as you like or get rid of it. The object can be the first word preceding the verb and the subject. Here, فَرِيقًا كَذَّبُوا وَفَرِيقًا يَقْتُلُونَ. Here, كَذَّبُوا is a verb. And the fa'il, the waw. وَفَرِيقًا يَقْتُلُونَ. Here, this, the object, the noun which has fatha, is the object. And the verb after it, the fa'il is the waw here. طيب. It could be optional like this one or mandatory if it is فَأَيَّ آيَاتِ اللَّهِ تُنْكِرُونَ, because أي is ism istifham, has to come in the beginning. Anyway, this is like branched from the subject. We're going to concentrate on the subject again. If we say قَامَ زَيْدٌ or يَقُومُ زَيْدٌ, this is when you mention the fa'il, when it is zahir or yani apparent or clear mentioned in the sentence. But if it is damir, it comes with the fa'il mudari' or madi or amr. Fa'il al-amr, the imperative verb, the subject has to be hidden pronoun. If you say iqra', okay, this is a sentence. Iqra is a verb. Where is the fa'il? Where is the subject? It's not mentioned there, but it's there. I can't see it. Where is the fa'il? The fa'il is damir, but it's hidden now. La, if you say iqra, iqra, I'm talking to, huh? Mukhatab, second person. Hawa is the third person. If you say iqra, means I'm talking to whom now? Anta, huh? Anta, you. صح? Yes, the second person, مخاطب. اقرأ means read. You are talking to the person front of you, مخاطب, the second person. Yes, command, yes, command, yes. فعل أمر. We call it imperative or command. Or فعل أمر. Where is the فاعل in the sentence? You can't write it. It has to be hidden. In the sentence, in the Arabic sentence, we can say اقرأ أنت. This is not فصح. We just hide the ضمير. You will understand that you are talking to someone مخاطب. يعني you're talking to the second person. You're telling him اقرأ. If I'm talking to the feminine, I have to say اقرأي. طيب. يعني it's not written, يعني it's hidden. Note that in Arabic, it is not necessary to use the personal pronouns in front of the verb. This is because the conjugated verb itself makes it clear who the subject is. This is the last part of the class today. الفاعل هو الاسم المرفوع المذكور قبله فعله. The subject is the مرفوع noun, which the verb, its verb is mentioned before it. Remember, the verb has to come before the فاعل. Here we have مرفوعات الأسماء. We're gonna see 7 classes we have مرفوعات الأسماء. The first one, الفاعل, the subject, the doer, which is مرفوع noun and the verb is before it. باب الفاعل. This subject, this chapter, we're talking about الفاعل, the subject. وهو على قسمين. It comes into two pictures or types. It could be ظاهر, يعني mentioned in the sentence here. All of this blue is the فاعل. Or مضمر, the red one, ضمير. يعني pronoun. والمضمر, the ضمائر, 12 means we have 12 ضمير. Now we're gonna read the ظاهر one, the one which is mentioned. We start with single noun, singular noun قام زيد. You make إعراب قام فعل ماض مبني على الفتح زيد فاعل مرفوع علامة رفعه الضمة. Yes, مستتر هيدن. Yes. If you understand type 1 or الحمد لله or anything. قام زيد فعل ماضي مبني على الفتح زيد فاعل مرفوع علامة رفعه الضمة. This is فعل ماضي and you could also make it مضارع. يقوم فعل مضارع مرفوع علامة رفعه الضمة زيد فاعل مرفوع علامة رفعه الضمة. الحمد لله. Also for the feminine, the singular feminine, المفرد المؤنث قامت you have to have تاء. هند or تقوم هند. طيب for the دول or مثنى قام الزيداني to زيد يعني الطالبان البنتان الولدان الرجلان. You could make any يعني just this example. All of them have فعل ماضي مبني على الفتح أو فعل مضارع مرفوع بالضمة مرفوع علامة رفعه الضمة. Okay. Sometimes you have تاء for the feminine. الهند هند الهنداني to هند الهندان. قامت وتقوم. You notice when it is فعل ماضي the تاء comes at the end when it is مضارع the تاء come in the beginning for the feminine. قام الزيدون. الزيدون فاعل جمع مذكر سالم. This is masculine plural. جمع مذكر سالم مرفوع علامة رفعه الواو. Like you say المؤمنون المسلمون القانتون الصادقون. All of this could be فاعل and we treat them as a singular for the verb. قام الزيدون يقوم الزيدون فعل ماضي مبني على الفتح أو فعل مضارع مرفوع علامة رفعه الضم. طيب for the singular hand we put تاء. He's supposed to say تقوم here because he forgot the symbol. قامت تقوم الهندان دول يعني مثنى علامة رفعه الألف. For مثنى الرفع الألف. For the مفرد الرفع علامة ضمة. The sign is ضمة. For the مثنى the دول علامة الرفع الألف. For the جمع مذكر سالم علامة الرفع the sign is واو. For جمع المؤنث السالم the sign is ضمة. قامت الهندات تقوم الهندات. قام الرجال this is جمع تكسير the sign is ضمة. We treat it as a مفرد also. يقوم الرجال. قامت الهنود تقوم الهنود. This is also as a جمع تكسير the broken plural. قام أخوك. This is from أسماء خمسة. أسماء خمسة علامة الرفع الواو as a فاعل subject. This كاف is مضاف إليه. يقوم أخوك علامة الرفع for the فاعل is واو because أسماء خمسة. قام غلامي. Here you don't find the sign of رفع. It is مقدرة. مقدرة means we imagine it's there. الضمة. Why? Because يا المتكلم غلامي something related to me. It has to be preceded by كسرة. But over there, there is the ضمة. The place of ضمة is occupied مشغول. يعني occupied by the كسرة which matching the ياء. Then here we say the dhamma is مقدرة. منع من ظهورها اشتغال المحل بالمناسبة. يعني there is dhamma there but I can't pronounce it because to match the ya of the متكلم the speaker say غلامي كتابي. You have to have كسرة before the ya. You can't have dhamma before the ya. This means you have to occupy this place with كسرة, but it's supposed to be ضمة because it's فاعل. We say the ضمة مقدرة implied here. طيب. قام يقوم غلامي and whatever like this. يعني. Here for the ضمير, for the مفرد, the first one, the speaker, it could be a singular one. I say the رب to urda rabbana. We talked this before. We said that the fi'l madi could be mabni ala al-fath like qama, or mabni ala al-sukun when it is connected with damir al-raf' al-mutaharrik. You remember we talked this when we reviewed the af'al, the verbs, when the fi'l madi is connected to damir al-raf' al-mutaharrik, we make it mabni ala al-sukun. Mabni, daraba is the end of the verb. Mabni ala al-sukun because it's connected with damir al-raf' al-mutaharrik. Damir al-raf', the raf' pronoun here is the speaker. The first one, the singular one, daraba tu. This means I treat this ta or I make i'rab for it as fa'il, subject, the one who made darb. Yani I hit daraba tu. I hit the fly, for example. Daraba tu. طيب, the ta is the fa'il, the subject. Mabni, all the dama'ir mabni. All the dama'ir mabni. You don't say marfu'a, you say mabni ala dham. طيب, darabna. It ends with alif, means mabni ala sukun. This na al fa'ilin. Na al fa'ilin means the na of the subject. We are the people who hit. Darab, the end of the verb فعل ماضي مبني على السكون because it's connected with ضمير الرفع المتحرك which is تاء الفاعل or نا الفاعلين or darab تاء تاء means أنت this تاء for مخاطب singular masculine we say darab تاء أنت for the male darab تاء without ياء the تاء is the فاعل the subject here مبني على الضم مبني على السكون because ends with ألف مبني على الفتح for the مخاطب the second person singular masculine the second person singular feminine with كسر ضرب تي تاء is فاعل مبني على الكسر ضرب توما this تاء مبني على الضم for the dual مثنى فاعل مبني على الضم for the plural because the meme for the plural the masculine plural ضربتم طب ضربتن this for نون النسوة this for the تاء مبني على الضم for the feminine plural ضرب here فعل ماضي where the فاعل the subject is hidden مستتر what you could guess it ضرب هو هنا the subject is هو ضربت هي how you know هي here feminine because تأنيث it takes feminine a female after it ضرب this ألف is the subject مبني على السكون فاعل ضربوا واو الجماعة is the فاعل the subject ضربنا نون النسوة is the subject here ضمير رفع متحرك also this مبني على السكون. طيب, I'm gonna repeat again. There are 12 pronouns. Two for the speakers. We said, darabatu, this is the first speaker. Darabana, the second speaker, which is the plural. We don't have more speakers. Only darabatu, darabana. طيب, for the مخاطب, we have five. Yeah, second person, you have five. Which you say, darabata, for the singular مخاطب or second person, you're talking to him in masculine, singular one. Darabata. For the feminine, this is the second one, darabati. For the dual, darabatuma. This includes the masculine and the feminine. For both, you say darabatuma. طيب, now we have three. Darabatum for the plural. This could be four. Darabatum wa darabatun. This is the speaker or mukhatab or five mukhatab. For absent or غائب, you have third person, you have also five. One, two, three, four, five. ضرب هو, ضربت هي, ضرب the alif as dual. ضربوا, this for هما, this for هم, ضربنا هن. Alhamdulillah is clear, right? But maybe this is the first time you listen for this. You might review it once and twice, thrice until you are good in it. And after that, after you review and listen for the video many times and take the PDF, inshallah. If you have question after reviewing, then let me know, inshallah, in the service to answer any question. But not now, because it might be new for you. You need to review many times, okay? The modmar pronoun, we have 7 forms of ta al fa'il. As you can see, it could be mabni on dam or fath or kasr. As you can see, ta al fa'il mabni sometimes on dam, sometimes on fath for the mukhatab, the second person singular, or mabni on kasr. Tab mabni on dam, we have 1 for the singular speaker and for the dual, males and females, this will be 3. For the jama', mudhakkar, masculine, plural, this 4. And for jama', mu'annas, this 5. It could be mabni on dam or fath or kas. Mabni on dam, we said the mutakallim, the speaker, the first person, singular speaker, you saw it already. 5 mukhatab, second person, dual, masculine, plural, all of this we have it already. You could apply on the chart and you find yourself, inshallah, very good in this by the time. Now, al-fa'ilin, because induz alif is mabni on sukoon. Tayyib. The damir is attached. Now we have some examples. I'm gonna ask you. It's very easy to discover where the fa'il, where the subject. If I say ja'akum yusufu, where the fa'il? Tell me, yalla, right. Where the fa'il? Huh? Yusuf, yeah. The noun which has dhamma, marfu'a. But if I say la tufsidu, where the fa'il? Where the subject? It's very easy. It's pronoun here. لا تفسدوا في الأرض. The wow, yes, mashallah. قالوا, where the فاعل? What the subject? Also the wow. طيب, وجاء المعذرون. المعذرون, this جمع مذكر سالم is the فاعل. All of it. المعذرون, جمع مذكر سالم is the فاعل. This is المعذرون. All of it, the subject. طيب يوم يقوم الناس where the فاعل الناس what type of word الناس is جمع ها جمع تكسير طيب ويومئذ يفرح المؤمنون where the فاعل after the verb right away المؤمنون المؤمنون What time we say the wow if we have it connected to the verb? But if it is noun, al-mu'adhirun, this jam'a muzakkar salim, all of it, all the word will be the fa'il. All the word. Al-mu'minuna, all the word. What time we say the wow if it is connected to the verb? Huh? طيب, qala Allahu, where the fa'il? It's very easy, huh? Very clear. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is the one who said, the one who talked. قال الله صح طيب الله يستهزئ بهم here where the subject الله يستهزئ بهم where the subject you can say الله because الله came before the verb this would be مبتدا this is what I told you before it can't be before the verb remember this is مبتدا now الله here is مبتدا يستهزئ بهم Where the fa'il? It's hidden. It must be there, but I can't see it. It's a hidden pronoun. Huh? يستهزئ هو. Huh? ضمير مستتر. تقديره هو. هو يعود على الله. You have to say هو here. After يستهزئ, you say هو. This is a fa'il. يستهزئ بهم ويمدهم. Same, يمدهم. The other verb doesn't have, the subject is not written. But you could imagine it's there because it's a hidden damir pronoun. It's هو. طيب قالت نملة. ها where the subject؟ قالت نملة. نملة the ant was talking. The one who did the verb, the نملة is a فاعل كلمة here noun مرفوع. طيب why we put that for the verb? Because it's a feminine, a female نملة. Like the sun also نملة. طيب لقد خلقنا الإنسان. Where the subject? الإنسان. Where the subject? أين الفاعل؟ ها نا ما شاء الله كفيلة. نا الفاعلين خلق. This فعل ماضي مبني على السكون لاتصاله بضمير الرفع المتحرك which is نا. نا is ضمير الفاعل. نا الفاعلين فاعل مبني على السكون because ends with ألف. ده ألف always ساكن. طيب الإنسان here مفعول به or object منصوبة. تنزل الملائكة والروح. ورد فاعل الملائكة والروح. This واو واو العطف والروح also فاعل follow الفاعل. This is we have follower. This is one of the تابع or follower for the مرفوع because we have عطف here. Remember, we say we have four types of تابع or follower. One of them, العطف. يعني it follows the preceding word in the same إعراب. مرفوع اسم مرفوع like the preceding one. This فاعل and this follow the فاعل مرفوع like it. طيب, قال موسى. Where the فاعل? Where the subject? موسى. مرفوع. Where the رفع? I can't see رفع. Where the رفع? ضمة ها وير ذا ضمة وير ذا ضمة نو مقدرة مقدرة. Why can't I pronounce ضمة or why can't I pronounce the ضمة on موسى? Why? It's impossible, right? Impossible to pronounce ضمة on the ألف. The ألف always ساكن. لا لا ليست مبني. It's معرب but ضمة مقدرة. ضمة مقدرة means we imagine that there is ضمة there but I can't pronounce it because it's impossible to pronounce ضمة on the ألف. موسى ends with ألف right. ضمة مقدرة يعني we imagine that it's there. لا يعلمهم إلا الله. Only Allah knows them. Where the subject? لا يعلمهم إلا الله. Allah only knows them. Where the subject? Allah سبحانه وتعالى. جاءتهم رسلهم بالبينات. Where the فاعل? Where the subject? جاءتهم. Who came? Who جاءتهم رسلهم. الرسل. The prophets came to them. With bayinat, with clear proofs. Huh? Rusul, the fa'al. You have the ends with dhamma until the lam. Rusulu, plural. Not rasul, this is plural. Rusul, jam'a, taksir. طيب. وَنُقَلِّبُ أَفْئِدَتَهُمْ. Ah, where the fa'al? وَنُقَلِّبُ. Here the verb, and this is mansuba. This means there supposed to be fa'il here in the middle, but is hidden. Damir, can you, yes, nahnu, yes, we, nahnu. Nahnu, wa nuqallibu. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala sometimes talk about himself with a singular damir. Yakhluqu Allahu, yakhluqu. Sometimes khalaqna, khalaqna al-insan. Na here. For the plural, but for Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, he's one, he's only one. But this for the majesty, العظمه, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is the king of the kings, Malik al-Muluk. He can say, خلقنا ونقلب, huh? جعلنا, طيب, he's one, but he's talking with the noon because he is the king of the kings for the majesty of him. ونقلبه. The فاعل is hidden, ضمير مستتر تقديره, يعني we could guess it that نحن, ونقلب نحن أفئدتهم. Their hearts, Allah سبحانه وتعالى is turning their hearts, turning all the hearts سبحانه وتعالى. تزعمون, this فعل من الأفعال الخمسة, where the فاعل, where the subject, wow, because it's connected to the verb, we say the wow is فاعل. The wow ضمير, connected ضمير, مبني على السكون في محل رفع فاعل. طيب ما أنزل الله, where the فاعل is clear, طيب تخافون, تخافون where the فاعل, the wow, yes, this فعل من الأفعال الخمسة, the فاعل is the wow. أن يتخطفكم الناس, الناس فاعل, this جمع تكسير, وقال الملك, easy, very easy to find the فاعل, it's very easy to find the subject, it's very interested, and all the time you find the sentence has فاعل. يعني 90% of the sentences when it is verbal sentence you have to find the فاعل. وتطمئن قلوبنا, قلوب جمع تكسير, is the فاعل. We will have tranquility. قال الحواريون, where the فاعل, جمع مذكر سالم, all of it, when it is noun, all the noun, all the noun, what time we say the wow if it is connected to the verb, فعل من الأفعال الخمسة will be wow. أمرهم أبوهم, أمرهم أبوهم, here where the فاعل, what type of verb this, أبوهم, أبو من من الأسماء الخمس, أسماء الخمس, أبوهم, قال أبوهم the same. يجمع الله الرسل فيقول, يجمع الله, here the subject is, الفاعل is, الله سبحانه وتعالى, who will gather the messengers, فيقول, فيقول, where the فاعل, هو ضمير مستتر, here hidden pronoun, if it is not written here means it's hidden pronoun. وقالت اليهود, اليهود فاعل. قال رجلان, where the subject, رجلان مثنى, دول, علامة الرفع ألف, فلنعم المجيبون, المجيبون جمع مذكر سالم, the فاعل, the sign of رفع واو, but the فاعل all of the word, but the sign is well, جمع مذكر سالم, masculine plural. يسبح له فيها بالغدو والآصال رجال, where the فاعل, رجال, ما شاء الله, وهيدة, رجال, رجال, you see where the فاعل is very far, it's after the verb, but you have sentence before it, doesn't matter. We have to look for the مرفوع noun will be the فاعل. Or ضمير, or if it is hidden, we guess it. وأنكحوا, where the فاعل, أنكحوا فعل ماضي مبني على الضم للاتصالي بواو الجماعة, واو الجماعة is the فاعل, واو الجماعة is the فاعل, the subject. وليستعفف الذين, وده فاعل, الذين اسم موصول مبني على الفتح في محل رفع, in the place of رفع as فاعل. طيب قد أفلح المؤمنون, who are the successful, the believers, المؤمنون ده فاعل ده subject جمع مذكر سالم جمع مذكر سالم if it is noun all the word is فاعل جمع مذكر سالم and the sign of رفع is the well come فأنذر where the فاعل for come what is the فاعل come stand up أنت ضمير مستتر hidden pronoun تقديره you guess it as أنت فأنذر أنت also when it is imperative or command or فعل أمر the subject is الفعل is ضمير hidden pronoun like اقرأ باسم ربك ها also the ضمير here أنت أنت قم أنت فأنذر أنت اقرأ أنت باسم ربك وقال الظالمون where the فاعل who said الظالمون this is the subject الفاعل الفاعل the whole word the whole word الظالمون جمع مذكر سالم and the sign is the واو علامة الرفع الواو وقال نسوة نسوة is the subject. طيب we done الحمد لله with the class. Any question? طيب الحمد لله. إن شاء الله you're gonna review only 3 pages. We're gonna send you the PDF or the handout. Review very well. Watch the video many times until you are perfect. And come next time, inshallah, we apply on the Mus'haf, one page on the Mus'haf to make it more and more good in it, inshallah. طيب سبحانك اللهم وبحمدك أشهد أن لا إله إلا أنت أستغفرك وأتوب إليك جزاكم الله خيرا والسلام عليكم ورحمة الله وبركاته.